That's the gates. Come on in. I'm going to show you the current scene right now. I'm on Nantmeal and Fairview Avenue. Come on in, everyone. The SWAT is leaving. The SWAT is leaving. Look at this tank. Look at this tank. SWAT. ATF is here. Well, they were here. So there was a large military presence of men, I would say about 30 to 40 men in military fatigues. Canine. So they were all coming out of this Nantmeal United Methodist Church. It's cool now because I have a good reception. How's the reception? Is the reception good right now? Let me know what the reception's like here and then we will proceed. Thank you, appreciate it. Thank you. They're gonna be back here tomorrow. Good, thank you. Here they come. There's more of them coming. They had dogs. These are all military, ATF. These are ATF agents. The ATF, this is the ATF crew. I don't know if they're gonna be back today. So what's going on? Oh, let me show you something. I want to show you something, right? I'm going to show you right over here, right? Because this is an apartment complex here. And this is like, his van was found. His van was found right over there. But I want to show you something that's apartment complex. Let me get my battery charger. Let me get my battery charger. So one of the gentlemen there, someone that lives here in this apartment complex, that I can go down there and show. I'm going to. Give me 1 second. Let me put the battery pack in. I want to show you tunnels. I want to show you there's crawl spaces and tunnels in this area. And I want to show it to you because there's some disturbing. Here we go. All right. I'm going to show you about this. All right, so this is right next to the Nantmeal United Methodist Church. I met a neighbor that lives in this apartment building here. This is an apartment building. And his vehicle was found right over there. His vehicle was found right over there. Not his vehicle, but the white van. And you see a large media presence here. But they said that authorities, I'm gonna show them the tunnel. I'm gonna show them the tunnel. Is that cool? Thank you. All right, so look at this. Look at this, because he don't want to be on camera, but he's cool. He's cool. And he said, yo, bro, check this out. Like right here, like right at their, he said, this basement here stays always unlocked. And see if there's a light. He said, back here, there's tunnels, dude. There's tunnels. And this is part of, I can't get the other light, but let me see where the other light is. But he said, this is part of the Underground Railroad system. And in the back, sorry, kind of went out. Yeah, it's scary. I'm going to get my flashlight and then show you. It's wild. But he's like, dude, that dude could have went into these tunnels and was like hiding out in the tunnels. Let me get that. As soon as I get this flashlight, we'll be able to see. Got it. Got the flashlight, folks. I got the flashlight. able to go in with the flashlight and we're gonna see. We're gonna see some tunnels. Yeah, there's tunnels back here, dude. There's literally tunnels back here. There's literally tunnels. And his name, he lives here, and he's like, dude, he could have came in here. He could have came in here because this is like right down the street. Like it's like literally right over there. They're searching, the SWAT team and the CERT and the ATF and state police and everything like that. They're searching right next door. And he's like, dude, this dude could have very well came in here. And you know when a fugitive could come in here and then basically back here is these tunnels. The reception gets bad, but you guys get what I'm saying. I can't get over there because the reception's bad, but there's tunnels back, folks. There's tunnels. And it's part of the Underground Railroad system. Let me go. See what I'm saying? Way in the back. And it keeps going. And I'm not exaggerating here. It literally, he said it goes all the way back underground. So I don't know where this dude is. But I'm telling you, people, they think he's still in this area. Until proven otherwise, until otherwise, they think he is here. They think he is somewhere in Chester County, all in this rural area. Now, I'm going to show you some things. I've been talking to everybody right here. The neighbors are so cool. The neighbors in this area are so cool. And the neighbors have been telling me that, one, a bunch of those neighbors told me yesterday authorities were going door to door asking them if they have any surveillance or any ring cameras or anything to, you know, that day. The owner of the church over here told me, that, and I talked to him, he's the president, he runs the church here. He told me that when the van got left there, that Sunday morning, they had church service there. They had church service there, and it all went down when authorities rushed to this location. They were having church service right here. And he was explaining the whole situation. I forget what he actually says, but he told me, I got an interview with him on camera, which is like totally, totally cool. So we're cool on that aspect. Over there is so much land and trees and rolling hills that it goes almost all the way to Route 100 from this location. He could be anywhere up out here. And we are like trenched in really, really far into the mountains. And I'm on Nantmeal and Fairview Road. It's gonna be like very, very... Well, the dogs are just people's local dogs, but around the corner there, this is where SWAT like emerged. And they... Now I asked the church guy, I was like, are you going to have service on Sunday if he's not found? And he actually said, yeah. He said, yeah. They said, he's not scared. They're not scared. This guy could be still in this area. This is the only area right here they are searching. In the backwoods there. Listen, I'm gonna post a video. There was two 18-year-old kids on a motorcycle. They were on a motorcycle and they came and they got out their motorcycle and they said they're specifically looking for this guy. And took their motorcycle like almost like vigilantes and was like, yeah, rock on, we're gonna find him. They went up right up, thank you. They went right up to a state trooper and the state troopers are still around, folks. See, state troopers are still around, they still patrol continuously around this area, around the clock. And they pulled right up to a state trooper who was blocking a cornfield and the state trooper just let him in and said, yeah, you can go look for him. I got video today, lots of video of camouflaged people in fatigues, on vehicles, horses, with dogs. It's a pretty wild scene around here. Now it's all calming down because it's about to get dark. This is another day this dude got away. This is the little kind of busy intersection tucked in. If you know the map, you'll know exactly where I'm at. But that's what's going on here in Chester County at this time. And I'm going to be back tomorrow morning to see, apparently the SWAT and all this is supposed to be a day-to-day staging ground. They're going to have to exhaust and go through all these trees here in all different locations around here and, you know, until they exhaust it. And then they might move on. But here's the thing is, at this time, there has been no reported any break-ins around here. There hasn't been any reports of any stolen vehicles. There hasn't been any surveillance of him anywhere outside this area where the van was left. Not at all. Nothing. So the locals, I'm telling you, the locals feel that he is in this location somewhere. They fear and feel that he is somewhere around here, hunkered down. And it's quite possible. I've also was looking at different creeks and streams that are nearby where this van was left. One is the South French Creek. Another concerning thing I have is, and this is interesting, is right where his van is, up the road is an elementary school. It's called French Creek Elementary School. And I don't know if it's open. I drove past earlier. Don't know if it's open, but this is kind of disturbing. I've seen numerous barns back here. I've seen sheds. I've seen outhouses. Richard Dawson YouTube channel. They need to be looking up as well as on the ground when they are searching. I think he is hiding up in the trees. There is a lot of trees around here, believe me. There's a lot of corn. There's a lot of valleys. It's not the Poconos, but it's like the beginning stages of the Pocono Mountains. It's starting to get rolling hills, but this is as deep entrenched in Chester County that you can be. It's probably one of the most densely areas of Chester County as far as rolling hills, valleys, streams, windy roads, just in this area. It's kind of coincidental. I don't think it's coincidental. It's kind of fishy that his car would suddenly be, or the vehicle that he ditched would suddenly be in this location. I think it's just kind of fishy about that scenario and situation. Nantmeal United Methodist Church. People are leaving. They're done for the day out here. I've been monitoring the situation. Will they expand the perimeter? That remains to be seen. But this is literally the only search area. And you saw them all leave at the beginning of this feed. This is the only search area that is visible to the eye. I have seen patrol people patrolling all around between here and Phoenixville. And I went out to Phoenixville, as we discussed earlier today. I went out to Phoenixville. I'm uploading a video now, and maybe it will upload finally, where I went to Bonnie Bray, trailer number 8. I knocked on the door, talked to someone on the surveillance over the Ring camera, the same Ring camera that got Danilo. So it'll be interesting. I don't know. They told me to leave. It's a wild case, people. We're in a wild situation. I'm out remotely. What do you think? Yeah, get thermals, get the ground radars, whatever you have. But they're going to have to go. There's so much land here. I don't know how they can feasibly be able to do it and determine, like, with just a small crew. Now, these guys, the people that were here, and they had ATF on their background. They have the ATFs on their back, you know, printed on their back. They were all military. They all had, you know, the radios in their ears. And they all looked like they were literally like National Guard people. And they had out-of-state plates and Maryland plates and Michigan plates. And, you know, it was a crew maybe of, like I said, maybe 30 to 40, 40, less than 50, but definitely more than 25, somewhere in that range. And, you know, they go through and they're trained and they know they're the best of the best, right? They're the best of the best at their field. But there's just the land here. And what do you do at that point? What does one do if you can't find him? If you can't find him at that point, do you just leave this area and assume he left if there's no proof he left? Because thus far, here's the situation and why everyone's like, is there sightings? Has there been any, you know, they ask that at the press conference every day. No, there hasn't been any sightings. The last actual sighting was him at the Ring camera, not the vehicle itself. The vehicle was dropped here Sunday morning sometime, but this actual sighting, the visual of him was on that night when he tried to attempt to go to a friend, or not a friend, but an old associate to try to, I don't know, we don't know, but the associate was communicating with him via that Ring camera and I guess called the police immediately, apparently, but the PSP, and here's another issue. Remember we heard the press conference today and the level of communication between the local police departments up in Phoenixville with the PSP. The PSP didn't get wind of what was going on for a few hours later, thus giving this guy a few hour head start to get away. So maybe in the future, there should be some sort of coordination where, you know, immediately if there's some sightings or something, it should be going to the PSP immediately. He had another 2 hour window, at least a 2 hour window to get away. Thank you very much. What we got there? Was van just pulled over on the shoulder, or was it pushed into the field? So it was around the corner. It was deliberately concealed. It was off into the corn and then around the bend where you can't see it from the road. That's what I'm told. That's where it was. So the average person that would go by would not be able to see it. Apparently what I'm hearing is they were able to pinpoint it via surveillance that took them to this location from different points from Phoenixville to here, and possibly GPS. But the GPS thing I'm a little suspect on, because if it was GPS that got that pinpointed, you would think, Jonathan. Thank you. God bless you. You said my name. Good job, Jonathan. You see that a lot of people watch from across the world. We watch the locals. The locals are amazing here. The locals. Listen, I had not one negative interaction with any local in this area. But going back to the GPS, right? The GPS. You would think, as soon as they identified the car was stolen, or the van was stolen, I think that was around, 5:30 he was trying to say? I saw a number, 5:30. I remember him saying at the press conference, Bivens. They would immediately be able to GPS it right away, but apparently, for some reason, they didn't. So I don't know about the GPS aspect and why it took them so long on that part. But where is he now? Where is this dude? 34 years old. 5 feet, 120 pounds, folks. 5 feet, 120 pounds. I am out on the scene. Listen, I'm going to go down to the Chester County, Southern Chester County area. I want to show you a few things, the aftermath of what happened down there. Some of us will call it a debacle. Some of us will say that was a debacle of what happened down there in Southern Chester County, where they had a perimeter. I was confident myself. I was so confident that they would have got him. They had all the, you know, technology. They had all the cars, the manpower pointing. But like Bivin said, you know, not everything is so secure, you know. And he slipped through a vulnerability place somewhere in that perimeter. Whether that was the tunnels, like there's tunnels here that I just showed you. If you just jumping on, check out the tunnels. There is tunnels. There's another PCP right here, PSP, Pennsylvania State Police. They are out. They are out. And I guess they'll be out here until further notice. So it's a wild scene in here in Chester County. I'm going to be here covering this case. What's your thoughts, everyone? I want to hear a little bit. I'll take a couple minutes to hear your thoughts on the situation. Will the SWAT be back here? I believe so. I don't think they were just going to leave this area for good without definitively. And if they do, I think they would leave because they got some new information, or, you know, figuring, what do we got here? What did you say? Deputies are vets as bounty hunters to go get them out. Easy peasy. MAGA. Sky Queen. Now, Sky Queen, thank you, and I appreciate that. Now, Sky Queen, like, here's the thing, though, is the police, or the PSP, Bivens, he doesn't want citizens out there because he thinks the citizens could get themselves hurt by being out there. He's not a proponent of that. But I can tell you that the residents here want to do that. I just talked to a resident beforehand that lived down there. He told me they were out there looking at his Ring camera. He was telling me a lot of the neighbors, because I guess they have one of these group chats that they all communicate with in, you know, like kind of like a Facebook group or whatnot. He was saying that they were discussing actually getting all together, the neighbors, and saying, hey, they'll go out on themselves. But they didn't have the drones and they didn't have certain things, and that's why they haven't done it. But I mean, will they eventually get impatient? Because if this guy is not found, and the guy, you already did an MURDER in Brazil, did it up here with his girlfriend with a knife. I mean, he was cold and calculated. You know, I got details of what he did down there in Brazil. He shot a man in his back. He shot a man in his back at the bar. And you know what's even crazy? I have more information that you might not know. He has a brother. Danilo has a brother from Brazil. And his own brother was cooperating with authorities against him there in Brazil on the gun case back in 2017. I find that odd because, or I find that ironic because his own brother cooperated against him down there. Now, he wasn't apprehended. He was able to flee, but his brother provided a law enforcement evidence or whatnot. He was able to flee and come here, and now the girlfriend, or his sister here, her boyfriend, the sister's boyfriend, cooperated against him. So it seems like people in his life have already cooperated against him. It's wild. And then what I even find even more wild is he chose to go back to the area where people cooperated against him with. You know, there was two guys that got immunity. That's so wild itself. Why would you go back to the same area and try to get hook up with acquaintances you really don't know like that? Dude has been incarcerated for 2-3 years sitting in the Chester County prison. You're gonna go back to an area and try to knock on somebody's door to try to get help on someone you don't really know like that, not expecting the person or call authorities and rat you out? Come on. That to me says that this guy is just a low IQ bonehead criminal. Though he's managed to elude authorities, he's managed to stay away from any detection. Hello, any detection whatsoever. Stay away from anybody, you know. So JLR investigates. I'm out on the scene. Thanks, Jonathan. Thanks, Marilyn. Thank you very much. So I'll keep you guys posted. I'm going to post a few videos soon this evening. It might come on later. If any new information breaks, like anything on the scanner or whatever like that, I will be out and I will be zooming to the scene. So we'll talk soon. Thanks for the support, everyone. I am out here in rural Chester County. Ground zero of the search here, but nothing is going on right now. Will it happen tomorrow? Remains to be seen. Stay tuned. We'll talk tomorrow. We'll talk later on today. We might talk at midnight. We'll see what happens. Have a great day. JLR Investing. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. See? Community likes me. I like that. I feel kind of blushing, flattered by that. We'll talk soon. Have a great day, guys.